If you intend to live the creative path and you say yes to it, it will lead you to your version of whatever you think we have that's beautiful. We are at home here, and it's taken a long time, and it was a bunch of yeses and a bunch of actions.
Oh, hey. Let's go talk about crystals. I love it.
We are special in our own way, but you're also special in your own way, and we all have this unique light. And it's really up to us to show up.
So this is our altar. It's the space in our home that requests that we alter ourselves. It's like our altering space. This altar has a lot of beautiful significance to myself, my husband, my mother-in-law who's living with us, my children, our present, our past, or the trajectory of what the future may be. And it's just kind of an offering. It's la ofrenda in my Mexican heritage. And in my Mexican culture, we have la ofrenda, which is kind of where we pay respect to our ancestors and the people that have passed on. And I've kind of remixed it a little bit, so I've made it and created my own version of it, where I put more, not that anyone is not a sentient being, I feel like we all are sentient beings, but it's where I put kind of these role models that inspire me to be better, that inspire my family to be better. I have the tiger, because it's the year of the tiger. I have Kuan Yin, because she's, you know, the role model for me as a female archetype on the planet, and just a reminder of compassion and peace. I have this beautiful brass teapot, and just reminds me of the spirit of tea, which is a practice that I have and I adore, and then I cultivate more and more and get to learn more about. I have the lion, which represents, you know, the lineage of my husband and his mother, and that is, you know, the Khalsa way, that is, you know, Sikh, that is the Singh, and the lion is kind of the embodiment of that, you know, animal spirit that supports and, you know, empowers more of this courageous bravery, you know, sovereign royal experience of life. And then I have the kids, little, you know, little surfer dudes and little surfer dudette, and, you know, on this beautiful crystal altar that is, you know, fluoride, rainbow fluoride. So Saraswati has a big presence here in Bali, the Dewi Saraswati. And these guys are just the Balinese archetype of the female Balinese praying and the male Balinese praying, and, you know, in prayer for gratitude, not for the sake of wanting anything, but for the sake of being fulfilled in the moment and in the present. And then this beautiful stone is a jasper stone that's mined here in Bali. And it's just kind of like the representation of having an offering and a place for me, for Bali, and being grateful to be on this island and to be sharing the affluency. And then this is spirit quartz. This is one of my favorite stones. This came to us from Canada, gifted to us by a dear friend of ours. And it is spirit quartz with like little baby merkabas. So merkabas is that sacred geometry of mer and ka, merging the heart into the present, into the space of the now. And I just kind of place them all here just to kind of amplify more of that. And spirit quartz is kind of like a remix around amethyst and clear quartz. And it's just, like a very heart-opening stone, more so than rose quartz. My matriarch. And this is Yogi Bhajan. He holds the lineage of Kundalini Yoga, and this is the medicine Buddha, which you saw in our room. This is Ganesh. He removes obstacles and clears the path, and also brings in some lessons as well. And this is Ravindra's grandfather and his grandmother. And this is some of the gurus, Guru Nanak, Guru Ramdas, legends. Legends! Yeah, it feels good, no?